Just a day after their homecoming following a dismal performance in the FIBA World Cup, Gilas Pilipinas head coach Yeng Guiao has decided to step down. In his resignation letter, Guiao said he is as disappointed as the rest of the Philippines' basketball fans over Gilas' winless stint in China. Guiao adds he takes full responsibility for the debacle. The decision to step down, Guiao says, will give the Samahang Basketbol ng Pilipinas, or SBP, a free hand in building and developing the country's hoops program. Guiao took over from Chotreas last year, guiding them to the fifth place in the Asian Games and a return to the FIBA World Cup. We now have on the line the Executive Director of the Samahang Basketbol ng Pilipinas, Mr. Sonny Barrios. Mr. Barrios, thank you so much for joining us here on Game Time.
Thank you rin for having me, Migs.
Sir Sonny, just want to ask, did Coach Yeng's resignation come as a surprise?
Not really. Because at the very start, if I remember right, he made a declaration that if we don't do well, he's taking full responsibility.
But now it's official. It was, you know, he formally, you know, submitted his resignation letter. Sir, were there any talks, at least when, you know, the team was in China na after na nga nung last game against Iran, he was really set in his mind na talagang, yes, I'm going to resign and step down to give way, of course, to SBP?
I really don't know what was going in his mind. What I do know is that upon arrival, in the very same day he arrived, he had a meeting with SBP President Alpan Lillo. I was not present, so I frankly don't know what took place. No, I just read the statement resignation of Coach Yeng this afternoon and the statement of SBP President Alpan Lillo. Basically accepting it and stating that he's thanking Yeng for all his contributions.
For you, Mr. Barrios, as one of the, of course, top officials in the SBP, your thoughts on, you know, the performance, the contributions of Coach Yeng Guiao, and how he has, you know, lifted also, of course, the Philippine national team, of course, from the Asian Games, tapos papasok na qualify from the FIBA World Cup and this stint, this tournament?
Well, the coaching job is always a tough job, no? That's why they have a saying, di ba, you're only as good as your last victory. Even there's a harsher saying, players win games, coaches lose them. So, hindi madali ang trabaho ng isang coach, and Coach Yeng knows that. That's why he also knows the expectations of our countrymen, especially being a basketball-loving country. So, handa naman siya dyan sa mga ganyan.
Mr. Sonny, now that Coach Yeng has resigned, it's time to move forward. When will SBP begin the selection process for a new coach?
Yesterday? No, I'm just kidding. Yes, the wheels will grind sooner than later because there is the Southeast Asian Games for one, which is already this December. The opening is on the 30th of November. So, as you know, Migs, hindi naman yan isang meeting meron na eh. It will be a series of meetings, consultations, and then the top management will announce the final pick or decision on who will coach, I suppose, first the team to the Southeast Asian Games before anything else, no? If you're talking semi long-term, who will handle the Gilas program for the 2023 World Cup, which we are hosting, palagay ko hindi naman yan mangyayari kaagad. But the discussions will start immediately.
Speaking of immediately, sir, Southeast Asian Games, just a few months away, who will be more or less members of the pool traditionally, when you go SEA Games, yung under-23 pool eh, ng Gilas. But right now, will there be talks of maybe a revamped team to, you know, mix it up? Maybe at least of Gilas veterans or, you know, yung mga under-23 players also, sir?
We submitted names of what you have just described, no? A mixture of PBA and non-PBA players or younger players who are not just in the PBA. That will be, of course, that list was submitted by Coach Yeng and his staff, no? Kung sino man yung ultimate coach will have to review that list. I don't know if we can change that list, no? Kasi may mga deadlines din yung FISCO, no? Yung Philippine Organizing Committee for Southeast Asian Games. So, iyan ang mga tatrabahuhin ng national coach natin.
Looking forward to 2023, at least just a bird's eye view, Mr. Barrios, do you feel or does the SBP feel right now that Gilas might need to look for another foreign coach who is an expert at the European style of play? We've seen it with other teams. Of course, they get reinforcement. Of course, yung veterano sa FIBA basketball. Of course, been successful also in international tournaments.
I can't speculate specifically, no, Mix, but what I can say is that all bets are off and all options are available to us. No, that's why it won't be an easy, immediate decision kasi it will take some pagsusuri and a lot of analysis, consultations, etc. No, before we arrive at who will ultimately head the coaching staff for 2023.
Lastly, if you will assess, Mr. Barrios, this whole FIBA World Cup campaign from the lead-up to the actual tournament and moving forward, what do you think needs to be done, of course, to revamp para mas palakasin pa yung Philippine National Basketball Team program?
Well, the so-called obvious thing to address is the preparation time. Lahat, no, including the millions of basketball fans / armchair coaches. Yan ang sinasabi, no? Yun na yung habaan ang preparasyon, no? Italy, for example, that joined the World Cup, they trained, I think, 3 or 4 months before the tournament, no? Just to give you an idea how other national teams prepare ahead of time. So, isa yan sa main concerns na dapat i-address.
Okay, so there you have it. The Executive Director of the Samahang Basketbol ng Pilipinas, Mr. Sonny Barrios. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us here on the show.
Welcome, Migs, and mabuhay kayo dyan.
Thank you.